back here with the bees. I haven't done hardly any bee videos this year, and that's because I've pretty much neglected my bees. And they don't seem any worse for it. It's been beautiful weather this week, so I'm really trying to feed them and help them out before winter as much as possible. I did work them the other day. I put some winter feeding patties in. I put my boxes with the cedar shavings on top. And I do that because one of the old timers in our bee club does it, and he said it seems to help with the mites because the cedar shavings are a natural miticide. So he does it every winter, and I thought if it's good enough for him, I'm doing it. So, and it also, because you've got this, you put screen on the bottom of your box and put the shavings on top of that, like window screen. Also, because you've got that layer on top of the hives, it seems to help absorb any condensation that might develop during the winter. And that certainly helps your bees too, because they can handle the cold. What they can't handle is the cold and getting wet inside the hive. So I do it. It's worked for me the last couple years, and I don't think it hurts. I've got some frames I'm letting them clean up back here, and of course the hornets have found them as well, so they're competing with the bees. But they're going to town. It's just amazing how they clean this stuff up. I've got three of them hanging over here. I'm just amazed what they can do. I mean, there's no sense you working at cleaning your frames. They'll do it. Just give it to them. Yeah. Busy. I had some rain and I drowned some of them. I felt bad about that. This one I had the lid on, and I don't think as much rain got in this tub. And the lid stayed on, amazingly. The other one blew off. I had that one covered too, but it blew off. Let me go to the other side, and I don't want to walk in front of their flight path. This is what I do. These are actually left from last year. I think they'll be fine for this year. We put the blocks on top of straw bales, and then we put the wood. Oh, there's a woolly bear. We put the sheet of plywood on top just to kind of help them. Of course, last winter was so mild, but just to keep the rain and snow off of them and yet still give them good ventilation. Because on the warm days, they will come out and fly around. So if it gets, you know, like 50, 60 degrees, you will see bees come out, maybe even warmer, I don't know. I worked them, like I said, the other day, and I've got my feeders on. There are feeders in all of these. I just put little jars inside. And then some of them I put on the outside. But a lot of activity. All four hives appeared to me, and this is my third year beekeeping, so I'm kind of, I'm a novice. So I consider myself a novice. But they look good to me. I was real happy with the amount of bees I saw and the amount of honey that they had. And if we don't have a really terrible winter, I think I might come out of it with four hives intact. The new hive, which is over here, these guys really have done well. I wished I would have put another honey super on them. I felt kind of bad that I didn't, because I think they would have filled it. But, oh well. Oh, look, what have I stuffed in here? Oh, a goof. That's a good place for that. Anyway, and I think they're doing quite well food-wise because these feeders have been on for a few days, and they aren't draining them. You can always tell when, like in the spring, when they're really hungry and they need food, these things, day and a half, they're gone. So that makes me feel pretty good. And this one has a feeder inside the box, a little pint one. But I think they've kicked the drones out for the year. They're really enjoying these last few warm days, though. It's going to turn cold for the weekend. But I've decided less is more with these bees. Last year I was back here about every week and I got stung so many times. I think they were sick of me. I think they just got sick of seeing me and got really annoyed. The first year I didn't do much with them and I didn't get stung once. This year I don't think I got stung once. Of course I wasn't back here that much, but I think they don't suffer from benign neglect. I think they do okay once you have if you have a strong hive to begin with. And this hive, am I going to remember which one it is? Ah! No, it's that one. Second from that end, that one right there. That's my original hive. That one is 3 years old. I've never requeened it. I think they requeen themselves. That's what I call my Amazon hive. That's where we took all the honey this year from. That hive just is an incredible hive as far as the amount of bees in it and the amount of honey it produces. I don't know what to think about it, but if something works, I'm not trying to fix it. Everybody says, oh, you should requeen every year. Well, they know how, you know. Yeah, maybe they'll have something will happen and they won't be successful, but my bumbling attempts at requeening are probably going to be far worse than what they could do themselves. So I leave that to them. They know when they need a new queen far better than I do. On this hive, I'm kind of experimenting. This is the only traditional hive I have. The other ones are little, they're nuke hives is what I call them. I like the smaller boxes, but this is my traditional one. Those are based on traditional beekeeping, but just smaller boxes. But this, I put a honey super on with a hole in the top so they could access it, and it seems to be working out quite well for them. Just something different. I like beekeeping. I wonder how long I'm going to have to do this before I feel I know what I'm doing. Probably decades, but it's very enjoyable, and I certainly reap the benefits in the garden. These guys were great little garden helpers this year with the produce. So there's a bee update. I know you like me to go in the boxes and see the bees and all that, but it's just too hard when I'm back here by myself to film and to keep track of what I'm supposed to be doing, and it takes all my concentration to work my bees. I've also taken all my queen excluders off for the winter, so the queen can go anywhere she wants in there. And some people don't use them at all. I do. During honey season, I keep her out of the honey boxes, but some people don't find that necessary. Maybe I won't eventually. Who knows? This is a box that I use with the cedar shavings. This one's got to be repaired. I just dumped it. The screen is coming apart from the box, as you can see. So I got to restaple that. But this is all you do, is you just put window screen in the bottom of an empty super, like a shallow super, or shallow box, and put cedar bedding in it, like you use for dog bedding or small pets. And it's a natural miticide. And I'll fill that to about a couple inches worth. Then you can set a pint jar of sugar syrup right in the middle, and they'll come up through the mesh, the bees will, and eat on that. And I found that the heat from the hive, because hot air rises, the heat from the hive will come up and it'll keep that sugar syrup from freezing longer into the fall. So that's what I mean when I was saying that there were feeders inside and that I'd put my boxes with cedar on. I just wanted to show you the patties that I'm going to be feeding this winter. I put in the hives. I got this from the Daydant company, and it has Honey Bee Healthy in it, which is a feeding supplement I use in the spring. It's made with lemongrass oil, and it's absolutely wonderful. The bees really seem to like it. It smells great. I like it. I always use that for spring feeding, and so these patties have it in it too. And what they come, a whole stack of them, and they come in these thin sheets between wax paper. And then, I'm not going to take the paper off of it. I have a couple left. But you can then, of course, my boxes are only 5 frames. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Most standard boxes are 10 frames. So in that case, you could lay it across the frame if you wanted. Or actually, you'd lay it in here so it would fit in the box. And just put it in between your boxes, or you can sneak it down between. And this takes, and just leave it in there like that. Great, now I gotta push that back up. what I like to do is bees work from the middle out. So a lot of times in your upper boxes, the frame way over on the side is empty. Depends. So that's where I'll put the patties, is on the side. Although the bees are gonna tend to cluster in the middle of the box. So if you can get them in the middle, that's probably better. The one hive back there, I wish I would have put another honey super in, because they have all their frames filled with honey. So I actually put another box on top and put 3 or 4 of these alongside, just hoping they can make use of it, you know, between now and winter, because eventually I have to take that box off because it's awfully tall. I don't want the winter winds to blow it over. But I've never used these before. lot of people in our bee club make their own. They call it fondant. And I probably will get to that point. I just thought, being it was my first time to use it, I'm going to order it online from a beekeeping supply house. We'll see how it goes. I've never fed my bees through the winter. And you can't use the sugar syrup because it will freeze. So this is what people resort to in the colder climates to feed their bees. And of course they just nibble on it. And I found this wax paper is a little difficult to get off. You can do it, but like this is peeling relatively easy. I had trouble back there when I was putting it on. But the bees will chew through it. It's not going to be a hardship for them. But anyway, that's what I'm going to be trying this winter. I don't know what kind of winter they're predicting. Last winter was a piece of cake for the bees and everybody else. I don't think we're going to get off quite so easy this winter. We'll see.